is it?
Hey, Gefjun's ghost! That's the largest bloody half-goof I've ever laid eyes on!
It's not just in pain. It's trying to sing.
It's the Song of the Sands. They don't normally sing like this underground.
Is that what's causing the storm?
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
Don't worry, Lunch. We'll get you out.
What is that name?
Well, the last squid thingy we saw was Diener, so...
Oh, boy. While I appreciate the attempt at humor, that little brother is truly awful wordplay. Embarrassing, really.
Oh, well, can't all be winners. There's gotta be a way to clear those rocks. Get a better angle. Can't get out.
Much of the hive matter is gone. We can free it from the surface now.
Why did they trap it down here?
Half-goofers are known to burrow, so I'd hesitate to place full blame on our dark elf friends.
But it's trapped in their hive stuff.
Hive matter doesn't belong to the dark elves, any more than the light belongs to the light elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources, one the elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the light elves seem keen to banish the hive over on their side, the dark elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
So, by clearing out all of this hive, are we hurting Dark Elves?
You wish to leave the creature enslaved?
No.
Then let us free it.
Thank you. spot. We can cut the half goofa loose here.
It flies. It's a half goofa.
Sounds much happier now. And hey, the storm's gone.
Aye. Perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father, thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnarok, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered... He just wants to spend time with you, lad. Well, he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead. But if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing us out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I.
Biggest thing you've ever fought?
I do not know.
You can't remember?
Why do you ask?
I don't know. So we can compare?
It's not a competition.
I mean, not yet. Something I'm not sure I quite understand. In the Ragnarok prophecy, Odin knows, all the realms get destroyed, including Asgard. While Virgin Gorilla kept secret, Asgard still falls. Wouldn't Odin have tried to prevent it either way? What difference did her lie really make?
I think of it this way. When it comes to subverting prophecy, knowledge is power. Without the full picture and context, the finer details can lead you to tragically incorrect interpretations.
Hold. What is that? These runes.
Mimir, wouldn't you prefer to face forward rather than backward?
We already tried.
There were issues with Viscera.
Oh.
Now, there was a brief bit where I thought I might get used to it.
He did not. Thank you.
Now, if I recall, we were discussing how manipulating the details of a prophecy can wreak havoc on the believers. Back in my homeland, I was privy to the operations of a certain coven of heat witches who were keen on destabilizing the government. They picked an influential thane, an otherwise loyal man, and fed him a story of his own ascension to king. They dressed it up in enough details they knew would come to pass, so when they did, the thane took it as confirmation. Thing you know, he's helping matters along. He murders his king, sleeping under his own roof. Murders many he once called friends, too, thinking them fated to oppose him. Then, for a finishing touch, the witches revisit this usurper. With just a few details structured ever so misleadingly, they convinced the fool he was invulnerable to all threats.
Physical or magical?
Aye, aye. But 'twas not so for him.
Enough. We will continue later.
These things smell awful.
No!
Cover! These bastards about to explode!
Go!
What has happened? They will dry.
You know, I just knew you were gonna say that.
Then why did you ask?
Really not sure.
They will dry.
Yeah, I'm sure they will. Father, why do I look like you?
In what way?
Like, bigger. When do I get muscles like yours?
When you work for them.
But Baldur was really strong, and he didn't have any muscles.
My strength does not come from my body, but both are honed by discipline.
What's that mean?
Means you've got the strength of a god no matter what, lad. But if you want the physique of one, you'd better start picking heavy things up and putting them back down. Brother, in my travels, I heard of a great battle in your homeland, at a place called the Gates of Fire.
The Hard Gates.
You were there?
No.
Is that regret in your voice?
I did regret not dying there for many years, but no longer. Why do you yawn?
Force of habit, I suppose, since I don't sleep anymore. Although, it's far more confounding that I'm the tired one. I've seen you stay awake for days at a time without so much as a drooping eyelid. Not even a nap.
God, do not nap.
Oh, tell that to Thor.
Go!
Did I ever tell the two of you how I made a small fortune in Asgard? Once, Balder arranged for every archer in the city to open fire on him. We took bets on how many arrows could be lodged in his body until the sheer weight of them made him fall down. Ha!
That's awful.
Oh, no, no. He was laughing the whole time. And mine was the closest guess. 446 arrows, exactly.
It's horrible. You better not tell that story in front of Freya.
Yes, lad. Because I've suddenly taken leave of my senses.
Just saying.
Huh?